What's going on, everyone? It's me, Connor's Car Reviews. As you can see, I'm sitting inside my mom's tracks right now, trying to make a video, trying to give an update out to everyone and stuff and see how things are going. Starting off with this, I am... Apologies for the road noise. Like I said, I'm sitting inside my mom's car and it's a little noisy out here, so deeply apologize for that. Starting things off, just want to say I've been busy and working a lot, so I'm sorry if I've not been able to make a lot of videos lately. I just put up a video today of a 2009 Nissan Altima 2.5S, if you guys want to check that one out. Also, too, I've been trying to look around and see what other cars I could find and shit to see what I could film and stuff. Apologies for the cussing. I've been extremely annoyed lately. So, if you hear me cussing, then I'm going to say it, though, but I deeply apologize for it. I've just been annoyed lately. Yeah, my car is still in the shop right now, so... y'all would keep my car in your thoughts and prayers and stuff. Been waiting for her for a good while now because of everything that needs to be done to her. It's gonna cost me a fortune at this point. Because honestly, my car is 16 years old. I can't say nothing. My car is literally 16 years old and it has been running ever since my mom and I first bought it when I was younger. And yet, what's really, like, coming as a surprise, though, like, right now, my car is getting the window fixed because the motor to the passenger side door window literally, like, took a dump on me, so I have to get either that or the window replaced and stuff, like, and it's kind of annoying me. I gotta get her registered again, and I gotta get her inspected and stuff, and I've gotta get a lot of other stuff done to her, which I'm getting kind of annoyed about on this. My car's been at the shop ever since I dropped it off there, and ever since we got Max back. But yeah. And I'm getting an idea at this point, because I don't even know if this will really work, but I want to try at least and try to get a, I gotta turn the car's power on again, because I gotta roll this window up, it's starting to rain. I had to do that because I had to shut the radio off because it was going to go off as soon as I, it was going to turn on as soon as I cut the car off again. Because it does this to me. Because it's a technology car. Can't say nothing. But either way, I'm just beyond livid at this point because my car is still in the shop. And I didn't really want to spill this out to you guys yet, but I might as well see how I'm bickering and all that, but I am currently in the market of looking in for a new house, like somewhere around where I'm living though. I'm living in Mohawk. As far as I can get with details, I'm basically just trying to find a cheap house for sale. Not expensive, but cheap. And unfortunately, no one around here has a house that's cheap enough for sale, and we're trying to get into a good one, and my mother and I cannot seem to find one. All the websites we searched on, no one has a house for sale that is cheap, which is killing me and my mother at this point. I didn't really want to spill this out too early, but I wound up doing so now because I started bickering and all that, so I know my mother would kill me if I ever said it on the live stream, but yeah, I could not help with spilling it out this time. And to make matters doubly worse, I have been working ever since July 8th of this year, and I've been completely annoyed at this point, because what's really killing me is because I wound up taking a vacation day from work on Wednesday, because I went out to see one of my family members who lives all the way out in Pennsylvania, which I should have found a dealership down there because I could have filmed a car while I was down there, but I didn't because I was busy trying to get directions and all that. So if anything for that, I deeply apologize, but still, I'm just beyond livid at this point because I'm trying to get plans done and stuff, and I'm trying to get everything worked out for a house, and I'm trying super, super hard to make videos for you guys. I hope you guys can respect the hard trying that I am going through with trying to get you guys videos and all that. And I actually am trying to get, I'm basically trying to get back over to United Auto Sales tomorrow so I can film some cars for you guys. I just don't know at this point how well this is gonna like turn out. Cause I mean, like, I love making videos for you guys, but ever since I became busy throughout my Mondays and throughout my Wednesdays, because I'm always at work on those 2 days, literally Monday and Wednesday. Excuse me. But Monday and Wednesday are usually my days to work, and I usually try every Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday to try to get down to United Auto Sales to see them, to try to see if I can film some cars. My last two videos I made over there, my last two previous videos that I made over there were on a 2020 Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross ES, and the other one was a 2020 Nissan Rogue Sport all-wheel drive. Which, don't get me wrong, those were really nice cars to film. It's just, I should have thought about getting at least like two more cars in one shot at least while I was up there at it, while I was at it up there. But I didn't really think about it because I was too concentrated on getting ready to try to get my mother out of there because it was starting to rain and stuff that day. So I didn't want to take too much of her time while we were up there, because even though I wouldn't have cared to get saturated that day, I wouldn't have cared, but the way that rain was coming down when we got home, oh my god. It's a good thing I only made two videos and got us both out of there. It was crazy. Now, to say the least, I am also currently in the market of looking for a new car. I have a few decisions, and if you guys want to help me with the opinion, please put your answers down in the comment section once I pronounce them out. So I will do that now. I'm looking into a 2014 Dodge Ram 1500 Transman Quad Cab. It's a 5-speed automatic, 5.7-liter Hemi V8, dual exhaust. Like I said, if you guys like that one, put your answers down in the comments if you like that one. But I'm not done yet because there's a few more. Looking into a 2014 Honda Accord LX, finished off in maroon, maroon burgundy, like that kind of color. I think the Accord that I'm looking into either has the V6 or the four cylinder. I don't know, but either way, that one should work. And these are the last two, and both of these are Chevys, hear me out. These two are literally both Chevys. No, was it last two? No, last three. And these three are literally Chevys. Hear me out. These last three are Chevys. First one is a 2017. No, wait. Do I want to shit? No. 2016 Chevy Trax LT with the 2.4 liter Ecotec 4-cylinder and a red exterior. If you guys like that one, please put yes in the comment section if you guys like that one. And here are the last two Chevys. 2017 Chevrolet Equinox finished off in dark blue and the 3.6 liter V6. Either way, and the last one, 2017 Chevrolet Sonic LT base model Sonic with lock unlock trunk release and panic with remote start as well, so it's basically like the key fob, like any other kind of Chevy would have, like a Malibu, an Impala, or Sonic. Like this one, like it would have lock, unlock, trunk release, remote start, and panic. I'm thinking of getting one of those kinds of the LT Sonic in from 2017. And the other one, and I'm adding in a bonus Chevy for this, for the opinions of the cars that I could do at least. It's a 2017 Chevy Trax LT. It's kind of similar to this one I'm sitting in, except it has a different front end, and it has LED tail lamps in the back. Some of the tail lamps on the 2017 models are half halogen, half LED. What in the name of blazes? As I was saying, sorry about that. As I was saying, the tail lamps that the 2017 Trax received, basically are half halogen, half LED. Basically, the turn signal parts of the tail lamps are LED, and like the other parts of the tail lamps are halogen. Basically, the other half red parts of the halogen tail lamps. They're basically halogen. Like when you go to lock and unlock your car, like say if it's the 2017 Trax, you go to lock and unlock it, those will blink off, letting you know that she's either locked or unlocked. That part of the tail lamp is halogen, where the turn signal parts of the tail lamps are LED. The backup lights in the tail lamps are halogen as well. But yeah. So if you guys want, pick any of those cars that I mentioned. Put your answer down in the comment section below of which one do you think would suit me more and stuff. If you guys have any questions for me on those cars, what I said about them and stuff, just ask me what I said and stuff. Just do what you want, I don't care. But as long as you guys get back to me on this stuff, I'm not fully worried. If you guys want to, go take a look at the video of the 2009 Nissan Altima 2.5S I put up today at my workplace. But yes, in all seriousness, I'm just looking forward to getting this progress done and over with. I'm not at all responsible for saying what I really want to say at this point, but in all seriousness, I am just trying to get plans together, trying to get as much plans as I want together so this way I can do whatever I need to do, get through work, find a new house and stuff. Like, I knew I wanted to say this a little later than usual, but I could not help with saying so because I knew I was going to be making an update video today, so couldn't help doing that while I was bickering and all that. But seriously though, I am just trying to get through everything. I hope you guys can respect the process that I'm trying to make with you guys on trying to make videos and all that. But Yeah. In all seriousness, I just cannot seem to get through everything at this point, but I'm gonna try my best, trying to get new videos and stuff. At my workplace, there is a Chevy Passenger Express van. If I could try to get that on my channel, at least possibly, I don't know, like Friday. If I can get that on my channel Friday, I should have no problem. At least I'll see what I can do. No promises, so I'll see what I can do at least. But yeah, at this point, I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. But yeah, but that concludes this update video. Y'all would please subscribe, like, and share. Like I said, keep my car in your thoughts and prayers, and I'll get back to you guys as soon as I can. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.